So last week we talked about napped stone tools that have flakes taken off of them to create generally points and sometimes pretty small points. Sometimes they're bigger, but you can see most of them in the late period especially are pretty small and pretty thin. But Native American people were also doing things that they needed more substantial lithic points for, like woodworking and some other kinds of food processing. So there was another way to make stone tools, and that's called grinding. And so grinding, typically you find the rock that you want to use, but you do have to shape it down a little bit. So this first one is a chisel, and you can see that it does have a few flakes napped off the edge of it. And so that was to get this general shape that they were looking for. But then they needed to get a long, thin point along the edge of it. And so to do that, you couldn't really just nap that off. You would want to grind it. And so grinding it essentially is kind of like using sandpaper on something. But of course, Native Americans didn't have sandpaper. But they had other things that were useful. So sometimes they would use sandstone. And we get those. We call them abraders when we find them. Usually it's sandstone with a long, thin line through it where they would have scraped this back and forth over and over to get to this sharp edge. And sometimes we find abraders that are made with daub. So a couple of weeks ago, we talked about daub. It's burned kind of silt clay material that came off of a house. So it gets really hard, but it's still a little bit rough. And so you could use that to rub against a stone like this to get to this nice sheen and this nice sharp edge along the length of this. And you could also use sand or silt and water to really get that last really fineness. If you've ever used like a rock tumbler, you know that you put in finer and finer sand in water and let it just grind down essentially until you get this really nice sheen. And they could shape it as they were doing that by going in different directions toward this tip. And so this one started off being napped and then was ground down. But then we've got a celt here that you can see all these rough bits here. And so it was shaped by pecking, which is taking another rock and kind of banging it against this to just break it down a little bit. So you're not flaking pieces off, but you're slowly kind of shaping it. And so you would have needed a rock that was kind of what you were already looking for in size and shape, but it just needed a little bit of work. But then you see that it's got these shiny surfaces. So after it was generally shaped, it was ground down the same way as that chisel was. But then also, this one's cool because you can see that on this end, it's not super sharp anymore and it's got a whole bunch of those little pecking marks. So this was used. Somebody made it and then used it for whatever they were using it for, and then lost it. We found it on the surface, so we don't have a lot of information about it, but it was discarded or lost by the person who made it and used it. And it's broken, so maybe they discarded it because it broke, or maybe it got broken after they discarded it, but it's pretty cool that we get to see evidence of it having been used. And then I've got a third one, and it's got that same sharp ground edge, but I think it was probably just made on a river cobble that they found, because on this side, you don't see any pecking, you don't see any flaking. It really just looks like I could have gone and pulled this out of a local river. Or a non-local lake. It's just a kind of a typical river rock. But it was the shape that they were looking for and that somebody needed, and so they ground it down and made this nice sharp edge along it. And then in addition to tools with sharp edges, people were also grinding things down for making flour and cooking and food processing and that kind of thing, and so we call this matate. But so essentially it's like used like a mortar and pestle that you might find today in a kitchen. I have one, but it's a little bit of a weird kitchen tool. But it's just a big heavy base that you can put spices or flour or grains that you're wanting to make into flour, things like that, that you will take another, you can see how it's kind of bowl shaped, so you'll put something in there and then you take another big rock and just grind it against there to break stuff down. And this one's interesting because it's got that bowl on this side, but then if you turn it over, it has another bowl on this side, which is a little bit deeper, but not substantially deeper. So I'm not sure why this is a double matate, but again, this is a find that we don't have a lot of information about, but you can see that rough interior surface where another rock and whatever they were processing was ground inside of there, and that rough surface helps the grinding. And then it also is evidence of the grinding. And another rock that's sort of like this that we sometimes find is called a nutting stone. And it's they're usually big rocks like this, but then they just have a small hole that's pressed down in there that you see it looks like kind of pecked out, like those little things, and they would have put acorns or other nuts in there and hit it with another stone to open it up to get that inside part that you eat of the nut out. And I don't have one of those right here readily available, but it's that same kind of process. It's just using it over and over creates these little holes in a big heavy stone where they would have been able to break into those nuts. So that's kind of a wrap up on groundstone tools. So I think next week I'm going to show you some kind of discard lithic material, fire cracked rock, just flakes that are unutilized and that kind of thing, just to show the whole amount of lithic material that we find on sites, because a lot of times that discard stuff is the majority of what we find. We find some of these more analyzable and like useful to tell us exactly what was going on kinds of things. We find a lot more kind of trash and debris stuff that just gives us kind of an idea what was going on at a site. So we'll talk about that, and then the following week we'll pick up another artifact type to talk about. So I will talk to you later. Bye.